Hello everyone. Today we will start part 3 of chapter number 1, Number Systems, class 9th standard. Today we will start exercise 1.2. So let's see question number 1. Question number 1 is state whether the following statements are true or false, and then you have to justify your answer. So let's see the first statement. First statement is every irrational number is a real number. So we have discussed what are the rational numbers and what are the irrational numbers, and then we have discussed about real numbers also. Real numbers are the collection of rational numbers as well as irrational numbers. That means real number consists of rational and irrational. So here it is written, collection of rational numbers and irrational numbers make real numbers. That means real numbers includes both rational plus irrational. That means every rational number is a real number and every rational number is also a real number. Therefore, our statement is true. Then second part, every point on the number line is of the form under root m, where m is a natural number. So here we know about the number line. Number line consists of 0, then towards the right hand side of 0, all the positive numbers, and towards the left hand side of 0, all the negative numbers. And we know that the square root of any natural number is always positive. So the number line consists of all positive and negative numbers, and the square root of any rational number is always positive, right? That means every point on the number line is not of the form under root of m or under root of n, where it is a natural number, as negative numbers are also there, right? In the statement, they are saying that every point is of the form under root m, and under root m means it should be a positive number because square root of any rational number is always positive. But we know that the number line consists of negative numbers also. That means the given statement is false. Now let's see third statement. Third statement is every real number is an irrational number. So just now we discussed that real numbers consist of rational numbers and irrational numbers. That means real number can be a rational number or can be an irrational number. So we know real numbers consist of rational and irrational number. Therefore, every real number cannot be an irrational, right? It's not compulsory that every real number will be rational. It can be rational also. Therefore, the given statement is false. Now let's see question number 2. Are the square roots of all positive integers irrational? And if not, give an example of the square root of the number that is a rational number. So in the question, they are asking whether the square root of all the positive integers are rational. So let's take the square root of a few positive integers one by one. Now first we are taking square root of 2. Now we know the square value of square root of 2 is 1.414 2135, and so on. It is not terminating. Not terminating means there is no and to its value. So but when we do the questions, in the last class also, when we did the questions, we use under root 2 as 1.414, right? But that is just the approximate value of under root 2. It is not the exact value. The exact value of under root 2 is 1.414 2135, and so on. There is no and to it. It is not terminating. Therefore, it is an irrational number. Same way, the square root of 3, the value of this is 1.732 0508, and so on. It is again non-terminating. There is no and to its value. So again, it is an irrational number. Now let's see square root of 4. Now square root of 4, if you will find, its value is 2 only. But 2 is a rational number. We can write 2 as 2 upon 1. So it is a rational number. Let's take one more example. Square root of 9. The value of square root of 9 is 3. So again, it is a rational number. Now again, if we will do square root of 16, then it will be 4. Value of this is 4. So that means square root of all the positive numbers is not irrational. So answer is no. The square root of all the positive integers is not irrational. For some values, we are getting rational numbers also. And examples already we have given all this. Now let's see question number 3. Question number 3 is show how under root 5 can be represented on the number line. So to under root 5 we know it is an irrational number. Now we have done representation of irrational numbers on the number line. We have done it for square root of 2 and under root 3 also we have done. Same way we will do for under root 5. See, first thing we will see that 5, if we will see this value, 5 we can get by doing the square of 2 square and 1 square, right? 2 square is 4 and 1 square is 1. So 4 plus 1 is 5. So we can directly do the, or we can directly represent the under root 5 on the number line, or if you want, you can do by the spiral method also. We can first show the under root 2, then under root 3, then under root 4, then under root 5. But for 5, we can directly also do, because 5 we can get by 2 square and 1 square. So here I have written the points. Let's see the steps one by one. Take a number line. So it is a number line. And here 0, then 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2. Then it is written mark a point at 0. So here mark a point O at 0 and A at 2. It is point A. Now side OA is equals to 2 unit. Now if you will see here, I have done here 5 means 2 square plus 1 square. So 2 square means in the number line we will take the side as 2 unit. So OA we are considering this, and this is of 2 unit. Why we are taking 2 unit? Because 5 we can get by 2 square plus 1 square. So side OA is equals to 2 unit. Now second statement. Draw BA perpendicular to OA. So here we have a perpendicular BA. This is BA. This is a perpendicular and its unit is 1. Right? We are taking 1 here because when we will make a right angle triangle, we will get 2 square plus 1 square. Join OB. Now we have joined the line OB. Now if you will see the triangle, triangle OAB, it is a right angle triangle. And in the right angle triangle, we can use the Pythagoras theorem, and which says, according to Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equals to base square plus perpendicular square. So here, hypotenuse OB is equals to, that will be equals to base square, that is 2 square, plus perpendicular square, that is 1 square. And after solving, we will get under root 5. So here, perpendicular base square plus perpendicular square, and we are getting under root 5. Now the side OB, this side OB is showing the under root 5. Now we have to represent this length OB on the number line. So for this, what we will do, we will use the compass with center O and radius OB and draw an arc. We will draw the arc, and this arc intersects the number line at point P. You can see this at point P. Now this point P will show under root 5. So if this is the same as we have done in case of to represent under root 2 and under root 3, it's same like that only.